And it's called The Plucky Squire. It's about this the squire, the little plucky squire. He's a guy right there in the middle, and he is actually a storybook character. It's like a children's book illustration kind of thing. And shenanigans happens where this evil wizard called Humphlegrump or something like that. I forget if that's the exact name, but he ends up taking over the store. He gets the power to leave the book, leave the 2D world of the book. He goes on the outside to the 3D world. He gets new powers. He comes back in and he takes over the book and takes over the world and stuff. And you have to stop him as a plucky squire. And you have your friends here, Violet, and I forget what his name is, but they join you on the quest and you do different things. So what makes this game so great, let's go to the trailer here, is the Plucky Squire. The art style is awesome. When you look at this here, the animation, it reminds me a lot of, not regular show, but it's a platformer. It reminds me of like Adventure Time. And it's a very, very sweet little story, very nice little game. And right here, where you just saw, you have the ability to jump out of the book into a 3D world, and you get powers to manipulate the book. You can actually close it, move the pages around, you can put stamps on it, you can write things and all this kind of stuff. And it changes the story, the actual children's book on the inside when you do that. And you can actually change the letters. Oh, I didn't see that part. Oh, I missed that. I'm about to go back and play that. There's a lot in this monster you could fight. That's pretty cool. But they do things in the story where you can actually change the words around. And when you do that, it will affect something in the book. So there's a part where you have to move a block. You have to move a rock from one side to the other. And it says this really big rock was in the way. And you can change big with another word to small. And this really small rock was in the way. And it'll change it from big to small. And then now you can go around the rock. I was like, oh, that's so cool. So there's a lot of puzzle solving elements in it that I thought was really neat. So not only does it look good, it's really cool gameplay elements. Like I said, it's a platformer and stuff like that, 3D and 2D. I thought it was a really simple game. It's something that your kid can put on, and or you can have an adult. You can play it yourself. I played it. I think I played it on, I don't know if there's an easy mode or something. I forget, but I think if there was an easy mode, I played it on easy mode because I didn't want to spend lots of hours trying to figure it out. But I thought it was still challenging for the puzzles and stuff. There were some things I didn't figure out right at the beginning, but it took a little bit. It's like, oh, okay, simple. And I thought it was fun. It's only about 8 hours to beat the whole thing. So if you don't get it free on PS Plus, you can get it for about $29 to $30 or something like that. And like I said, I beat it in 8 hours without doing the extras. And I saw some stuff in here. I was like, oh, I didn't do that. So there's some extras in here to keep you going if you want to get everything. I will say I almost platinumed the game. There's probably 3 or 4 trophies that I didn't get because I wasn't trying. As I played the game all the way through, just the story, I almost platinumed the whole game. So that should tell you how complex and how easy it really is. I'm not sure what else to say about it. The graphics are good. I would highly recommend this for, like I said, for kids, adults. If you want something fun, playability, I think it has replayability to it. You can try out different things, try out new things you didn't think of before. I would say probably has maybe 2 good playthroughs in it. And then after that, it probably, you know, that'd probably be it. That's the only downfall, I would say, is 2 good playthroughs. But other than that, there's not really much else to say. It's a really cool game. And yeah, I recommend it if you get a chance. That's The Plucky Squire. So that's it for this review, guys. Thank you for showing up again. This is me, Rough Reviews. Please like, share, subscribe to the video, subscribe to the channel. Like, share, and comment on the video, but subscribe to the channel. And yeah, keep showing up for more. I'm going to keep doing these, keep doing book, movie, video game, TV show reviews. And yeah, and keep at it. Keep sharing my experiences with you guys. But until then, I'll see you next time.